Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Perhaps this is your first time joining with us. We extend a welcome to you and trust that you are blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer. We want to continue to pray for our president and our nation. We want to continue to pray for our local community, and we want to continue to pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. Perhaps you have a special request. This is a perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, by the authority of the name of Jesus, we love you, we praise you, we thank you for the abundance of all things. Father, we pray for the continued protection of our president. We pray that you keep your hands on our nation in these troubling times. Father, we also want to pray for our local community and pray that you'll continue to open up doors of utterance that we can continue to witness and to share this great truth. And Father, we pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church and members in particular, and ask that you would open the windows of heaven and pour out provision, protection, and your presence. We ask all of this in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. And everybody said, amen. Praise God. I'd like to direct your attention to one verse of scripture here this morning, found in the book of Philippians, chapter number 3, and it's verse number 13. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. Forgetting those things which are behind. I want to talk to us for a few moments this morning about living with regrets. Living with regrets. I'm always fascinated when somebody talks about the potentialities and the powers of the human brain. It has over 100 billion brain cells and nerve endings, has an amazing capacity. Somebody sitting in a dark room came up with a number saying that the human brain was capable of storing more information than 4.7 billion books. I would love to have a conversation with that person, because I don't know how you could ever determine such a thing. But the facts are in that the human brain is the most incredible component of our being and comprises what we call the soul. Part of the human brain that we're fascinated with is this thing called the memory. The memory. It is the hippocampus that scientists tell us that is the component in our brains that store memories. And only recently, scientists have been able to break these memories down and put them in various classifications. There's short-term memory, long-term memory, and different types of memories. Well, I love what the Apostle Paul said. He said, forgetting those things which are behind. Of course, in this context, the Apostle Paul is juxtaposing, reaching for the things that were in Christ Jesus, the high calling which is in Christ Jesus, compared to his religious upbringing and all of the religious accoutrements that had filled his life. He was recognizing that I am forgetting all those things that are behind me. And I believe that even included persecuting Christians and being an unbeliever and being injurious to the church. You know, the reality of it is that living with regrets is simply being human. Many of the great patriarchs, some of the great heroes in the Word of God, lived with regret. Just a casual perusal, I believe that Abraham regretted listening to the pleas of his wife to go in unto Hagar. I believe that David regretted the day that he was on his rooftop and looked down and saw Bathsheba as she was bathing and began to set in motion an incredible sin that changed his life forever. We could go on all morning. Because the reality of it is, to be human is to live with regret. You have regrets, I have regrets. But we have to keep these regrets in proper perspective so that they do not crush us and they do not hinder us. Let us keep in mind that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I think that there is really a benefit in having regrets, because it helps us to avoid making the same mistakes or avoid certain traps, the snare of the fowler, certain sins, certain behaviors, whatever. Regrets are there that can ultimately be part of the learning curve. If your regrets come howling through the corridors of your mind and cause us to freeze with condemnation and shame, it's time to properly deal with those and realize that when we repent and when we confess and when we ask God to forgive us, when we renounce those very things that caused the regret, we are free to move on. The Bible tells us in the book of Revelation that they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. I believe that the word of their testimony is that component of our life that even though that there's regrets and mistakes, we never quit. Quitting is not part of the equation. And so regrets, everybody has them. I have regrets that I'm still living with when I recognize what type of child I was and what kind of teenager I was and how problematic I was to my parents. I have regrets that have filled the last 65 years of my life. But my regrets do not control me. I'm able to keep them in check by using the Word of God, the blood of Jesus Christ, and the infilling of the Holy Ghost, which is Christ in us, the hope of glory, that continues to talk to us and minister to us and advance us forward. Praise God. I know that there's probably many people that are viewing this here this morning that are thinking, you know, I wish I would have done that, and I wish I would have done that, and I wish I would have done that. You know what? Once you start down that road, it could take up a day and then another day and another day. And when it's all said and done, you've wasted the present by being eaten up by the regrets of the past. It's time for us to forget those things which are behind. You know, forgetting, scientists are starting to grapple with the human ability to forget, because it really is something that the human brain has. All of these capacities to hold on to memories, to explore the future through the imagination, somehow our brains are somehow held by the future, which is the imagination, and the past, which is the memory. But it's understanding our posture of who we are in Christ that helps us to balance all this in the now, in the present, so that our imagination does not generate fear of what could be, and our memory does not generate condemnation over what has been. The truth of the matter is, all of us are moving forward, all of us have regrets, and all of us have the ability to access grace. Keep going. Let your regrets be a learning curve instead of a downer. Let it take you to the next step. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here this morning. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.